Hello everyone, welcome to our Financial Solutions Today YouTube channel. So this is your online financial coaching. So please don't forget to click subscribe, okay, and click the bell button so that you will be notified sa mga susunod po natin mga online seminar. And I hope that this seminar, you're going to learn from it. Right now, so we are going to talk about cash flow. So yan po, napaka-importante, especially during this pandemic. No? Dahil ang dami pong naapektuhan ngayon. Sabi ng Dole, 2.75 million na raw ang nangangalib na mawala ng trabaho because a lot of businesses are shutting down. Okay, a lot of businesses are closing down. Ngayon, nakikita natin, napaka-importante po na maintindihan natin. The foundation po ng financial planning ay cash flow. Una natin kailangan maintindihan ay, like nga sinasabi, why don't we treat this pandemic as your retirement period? So ngayon, kung retirement mo na to at wala ka palang savings, so how are you going to survive? That's why ang definition ko ng wealth is, if you lose your income today, how many years you will survive? Nakita na natin na ang income, ang kinikita, is it permanent or temporary? It's temporary because you can lose it anytime. You can lose it when your company become bankrupt. Even if you have business, if you become bankrupt, you will lose your income. Ngayon nagkaroon ng crisis, if you are a no work, no pay, you lose your income. Disability, you can lose your income. Okay, even up to death, you can lose your income. And right now, bago ngayon, even in the midst of crisis, you can lose your income. So this is the reality of our situation right now. Income is temporary. But expenses, they are permanent. So that's really our biggest problem. So how are you going to balance temporary income versus permanent expenses? So right now, we have to make sure we understand cash flow. Deuteronomy 8:18 says, it is God who gives us the ability to produce wealth. It is God who gives us the ability to make money. So the foundation of cash flow is you have to keep on earning. Okay, you need to keep on making money as long as you have the strength, as long as you have the time. Keep on making money. It's God's promise. In New Century Version says, it is God who gives you the power to become rich. Proverbs 10:4 says, a lazy person will end up poor, but a hard worker will become rich. So meaning, this is really the time that you have to keep on making money. In fact, in Proverbs 6, verses 6 to 11, God even says, go to the unused laggard. Imagine dun tayo sa mga langgam pinapupunta kasi mga langgam, they keep on storing food so that they will be ready in rainy days. In fact, in verse 9, it says here, but you lazy bone, how long will you sleep? When will you wake up? A little extra sleep, a little more slumber, a little folding up the hands, then poverty will pounce you like a bandit. Scarcity will attack you like an armed robber. So meaning, during this time of pandemic, this is not the time that you stick your nose to Facebook, watching TV, doing home chores, sleeping a lot of hours. This is the time that you look for ways to earn income. This is really the time to make money. This is the time for productivity. You have to make sure that you are going to maximize the ability that God has placed in your heart. Remember, there is always opportunity in the midst of every crisis. Now, how did God is teaching us how to face this crisis? When you start making money, the next thing that you need to do is you start saving money. You make money, then portion of what you are making, you have to save it. In fact, it says in Proverbs 13:11, he who gathers money little by little makes it grow. The principle in cash flow is start saving now at any level of income. Yan yung sinasabi ni God na para kahit ilang maging katulad tayo ng mga langgam. Na they keep on making money, they keep on storing food. So the foundation of financial planning is you keep on making money. Then after you make money, you save money. Okay? Saving has nothing to do with the amount. It's not the amount, it's the discipline to save money. Every time God bless us, we have to set aside. It should be a lifestyle. Every time we make money, you have to set aside. So Proverbs 21:20 says, the wise have wealth and luxury, but fools spend whatever they get. So meaning, if you earn 20,000 and you spend it all, this, how does the Bible describe you? Fool. Because if you do it, okay, you will end up in poverty. So how do you save money? And I always teach this formula. I call it the 10-20-70 rule. Every time God blesses you, it has to be 10-20-70 rule. It should be a lifestyle. You don't need to wait for a crisis. It should be part of your lifestyle. It should be part of your routine. For example, you earn 20,000 pesos. 10% goes to your tithes. It belongs to God. 10% of 20,000, that's 2,000. Then 20% goes to your savings. Okay, keep 1/5 of every blessing God gave you. That's 20%. So 20% of the 20,000 is 4,000. So 4,000 plus 2,000, 6,000. You only focus your spending on the 70%. That's 14,000. Okay? Then the 14,000, you have to divide it between the wants versus needs. Are you buying the essentials? Are you buying something important? The things that you only need? Because if you don't do this formula, because a lot of people, I have been talking to a lot of people, sabi nila, 15,000 lang kinikita ko. Hindi ako makakasave. Pag naging 20,000 yan, magsasave na ako. Nung naging 20,000 na, sabi nila, ay kulang pala. Pag naging 30,000 na. So you see, it's not the amount. It's the discipline. Because whether your income is continuously increasing, you have to understand your lifestyle, your expenses also increasing. So we have to discipline ourselves. 10-20-70 is rule is the key in order for us to save a lot of money. Now when you save, it's not enough that you work hard to earn money. You need to make money work harder than you. Okay? Proverbs 13:22 says, a good man leaves an inheritance to his children's children. So we save so that in the future, we can leave an inheritance to our children's children. So I hope that you really learn from this principle, especially in this, the midst of this crisis. So these are just easy. The foundation of financial planning is cash flow. You keep on making money, you keep on earning. Then when you earn, you have to apply the 10-20-70 rule. Then from your savings, make sure that your savings, you have to make it grow so that your money will work for you. In our next session, so I will teach you how are you going to make your money work harder than you. So thank you so much for listening. I hope that you learned from this topic. And don't forget to click subscribe and click the bell button so that you will always be notified if we have a new online teaching that will be posted in our YouTube channel. Okay, just make sure you subscribe from our YouTube channel, you click the bell button, and don't forget also to like, okay, and share it to a lot of people, to the people that you care, to the people around you, to your relatives, to your friends, so that they will also learn and tell them that this session is truly life-changing. Thank you so much. See you around.